Hi. Welcome to Inside Us. In this video, we will talk about neck and head muscles or their lateral flexion. Lateral flexion of the neck and head refers to the movement where the head tilts towards one shoulder, bringing the ear closer to the shoulder on the same side. The lateral flexion of the neck and head involves the coordinated action of several muscles. Sternocleidomastoid. This muscle is one of the primary muscles involved in lateral flexion of the neck. It is located on each side of the neck and originates from the sternum and clavicle and inserts into the mastoid process of the temporal bone. When contracted on one side, it tilts the head towards that side. Scalene muscles. The scalene muscles, including the anterior, middle, and posterior scalene muscles, assist in lateral flexion of the neck. These muscles are located on the sides of the neck and connect the cervical vertebrae to the upper ribs. Their contraction helps to tilt the neck laterally. Splenius muscles. The splenius muscles, consisting of the splenius capitis and splenius cervices, are deep muscles located in the back of the neck. They extend from the vertebrae of the upper back and lower neck to the base of the skull. When contracted, these muscles assist in lateral flexion of the neck and head. Levator scapulae. The levator scapulae muscle is located on the side and back of the neck. It runs from the upper cervical vertebrae to the scapula. When contracted, it assists in elevating the scapula and contributes to lateral flexion of the neck. These muscles work in a coordinated manner to produce lateral flexion of the neck and head. When the muscles on one side of the neck contract, they create a bending force that tilts the head towards that side. The opposite side muscles may also provide some resistance to control the movement and maintain stability. That's it for today, hope you like this video. For more videos on human body and organ system, please subscribe to this channel. See you in the next video.